What's good, y'all? Waver Wednesday in the building. Welcome to my crown session video. If y'all haven't already, make sure y'all subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell for post notifications. Right now, you're looking at the crown area. As you can see, I did a washing style. I moisturized my whole pattern, but I didn't really pay too much attention to setting up my crown. That's just something that happens over time after my washing style process. I like to moisturize my whole head first and then come back and hit it with the moisturizing session for my crown. So let's go in and moisturize the crown. I'm going to show y'all what that's like. We can get a quick brush session in. Let's get it. For your crown area, it don't take too much. Just a few drops of oil in the crown will do. Remember, this is after I've already moisturized my whole pattern, so... yeah. So for this brush session, you're gonna need a brush with a point, as you can see there. It could be a hard brush and a soft brush, so I got both. But if you don't got both, just use what you can, which would be a comb and a brush that's hard, or a comb and a soft brush or a medium brush. But if you don't got a brush with a point on it, then you can use a comb to get in the crown area, and then you can go ahead and use the corner of your brush. So I got a soft brush here too, and you can use the corner of that brush, just the point of it, to get in your crown area. I'm not using a comb today. I'm gonna use the hard brush instead. When brushing the crown area, it's different, because what you're trying to do is get it to flow into the rest of your pattern. And the technique that I like to use is four corners. That's one, two, three, and four. So that's four different angles. I like to divide it up into four different angles. List the next angle. It's kind of going down, but a little bit to the left. And then this is the final angle, which is the fourth angle. Is going straight up and forward. Now what this hard brush is going to do, it's going to lift the hair up off your scalp. And that's why I'm not combing today. When I do use these brushes for my crown area, I don't really close my crown all the way, because I'm not really looking to get a very harsh swirl. Another thing that you may see me do is open it up. So what I would do is, I would pull it back this way. Because sometimes it's good to just open the crown area up. But I'm still hitting them same angles. And as you can see, it got like this line right there, but that's okay. I'm gonna show you how to close it. but with it being open. So it's kind of like going against the grain, if you will. I would say that you can do this if you got a lot of hair in your crown area. And the reason why I do this is to loosen up the swirl, because I'm not looking to get a harsh swirl and turn my waves into 540s. I just want the 360s. I want everything straight. And only thing I want to swirl is the crown area. I don't want my whole pattern ending up in the swirl. So that's why it's good to just and don't be scared to use more oil neither. I most definitely had to use more oil on my crown because it moves a lot better. So this side get a little tricky when going against the natural swirl pattern, because I gotta bring this right side kinda down and that way, and then when I get up to the top I gotta bring that down this way. And as I come around, I gotta bring it this way. Guys, we switching brushes. So the trick to opening your crown and closing it at the same time is simply, okay, you want to start from the very first ring. My first ring, it'll be right about here and here. So you want to direct your head with the flow of the rest of your pattern. You see? See how this ring goes down that way, and then as I come around, it go this way. So we got that, that, and then this ring do that. As I go out, then it goes up. It come around and down. And trust me, after moisturizing, I'm gonna go back to the first way that I brushed, but I at least leave it open for a day. one angle that my hair don't seem to like very much is this one. So from here, you see that the flow of my pattern go this way. It needs training to go forward like this. But over time, it will. So it's really just having patience. And that's on my right side. On my left side, it's really not that much of an issue. I can reverse my crown and it'll do just what I needed to on this left side. I think that it's more trained. This is good for people with beehives or even good for people with 540, 720s. It don't matter. As long as you're following your pattern. So what I mean by following your pattern, let's get the next brush. First, let's put butter in, a light butter for lay. Let's get that done and get that out the way. There we go. So by the flow of the pattern, I mean this. You see how in the pattern it goes down this way? You want to go with that. This way, it'll go this way. This way, this way, this way, and to the top like that. So if you got a regular brush, I'm just like you with this brush. I'm gonna use the tip of this to get into my crown instead of using the tip of this. And I'm gonna go with the flow on my pattern. Check this out. So from here, with the crown, I'm gonna come this way. And this is how I open up my crown. Open crown method. From here, I'm gonna come down and go this way. Here, I'm gonna come down and go like that. On the top, I'm gonna go straight forward. Very top, I'm gonna come straight forward. So the right top is on the right forward. The very top is straight forward. And then I'm gonna pick up where I left off. I'm not gonna overlap this brush angle with this one. The left top is gonna fall into the left a little bit, but not much, just enough. And you can see I'm using this tip of this brush on my head, right here in the crown area, and flowing it down to the left. It's still straight, it's not slanting. From here, I'm gonna take this and come down to my ear. So this was straight, this was to my ear. And then I'm gonna go straight down. And this is all within the crown. See, when I hit this angle, that's this way. But when I come over here, it's not the whole brush at that point. It's just this part of the brush. And then it'll just look like this. Same thing all the way around. Oh yeah, and then you also got the tap-tap method. Tap-tap method is this. You're hitting the crown. Tapping. Just tapping away. Y'all, that's pretty much my secret on how I brush my pattern going against my swirl. But when I do go against my swirl like that,
take a softie,
a finishing softie, and I do lay it down. Alright y'all, so to eliminate some of this frizz, let's use the chip bag method. Guys, so just to recap, you know, let's talk about it. The reason why I brush against my pattern slightly, not all the way, but slightly, because of problem areas like this. As you can see, the flow will come down, down, and then when it get to this fork need to be pushed that way. I got another one up here. It's hard to see because I've been using this method for a while. You can see it's about to connect right here. But this will go down this way. This fork needs to be pushed out that way. I got another one here from the crown. This one needs to be pushed that way. I got another one right here And from the crown, this one needs to be pushed that way. So with these two going straight like this, you can see my left side is starting to clear up. So from the crown area, these waves gonna push out that way. This gonna push down, down, and around. Reason being is because you want your crown area to match the rest of your pattern. You want your flow to come from in the crown and flow out, if that makes sense. To flow into your crown and out of your crown. You don't want to just have stuff crashing into your crown all crazy. So I hope this helped. If you liked the video, make sure you hit the thumbs up, comment, like, and subscribe. Peace.
And I'm sorry.